In this video, we will be demonstrating the Simple Harmonic Motion Kit, the ES7, an experiment within the engineering science range from TecQuipment. With this kit, you can carry out 6 different experiments that focus on simple harmonic motion in springs and pendulums. Students test different pendulums and a spring to see how different factors, such as mass or pendulum length, affect simple harmonic motion and the period of oscillation. Experiments include mass spring system, simple pendulums, compound pendulums, Cater's pendulum, bi-filar pendulums, and tri-filar pendulums. Simple harmonic motion is an important type of periodic oscillation. It's this movement back and forth of mass that is happening all around us. Understanding the relationship between the period and motion and restoring force by using springs and masses to understand simple harmonic motion lays the essential foundation for understanding more complicated vibrations and oscillations that applies to physics, mechanical engineering, or civil engineering study. Let's take a look around the kit now. All the elements needed are included in a plastic box with lid, including the pendulum, springs, mounting plate, weights, magnetic ruler, and stopwatch. The first experiment proves the theory for the mass spring system. A simple mass spring system moves with simple harmonic motion. That is because the restoring force for a spring is proportional to the displacement, obeying Hooke's law. Firstly, different weights are hung onto a spring and you measure the downward extension, then chart the results. Then you measure the up and down oscillations using the stopwatch to record how long it takes to complete 50 oscillations. You can then calculate how the theory matches up to reality. The second experiment proves the theory for simple pendulums. There are 2 different weighted pendulums. Firstly, select the lightest and set the string length to 500 millimeters. Then push it aside by 100 millimeters and allow it to swing freely. Using the stopwatch, you measure how long it takes to complete 50 swings and then again for different string lengths. Then repeat using the heavier pendulum. With all these results, the user guide steps you through charting the data and calculating the acceleration due to gravity. You're prompted to then compare the results with the textbook data supplied and think about how to improve experiment accuracy. The third experiment proves the theory for a compound pendulum. This is different as it has a solid rod with its own mass and a moment of inertia around its center of gravity. You fit the pendulum pivot like this, follow the specific measurements outlined in the user guide. Now you're ready to set the pendulum swinging and take recordings of how long it takes to complete those 50 swings with the pendulum pivot at different lengths. So now you can compare the actual period that you recorded against the theoretical period. Edward John Routh found that for a compound pendulum made of a thin rod, you can find a reasonably accurate radius of gyration using the total length. The fourth experiment provides the theory for Cater's pendulum. Henry Cater realized that an accurate pendulum will help you predict gravity accurately. For this, you experiment with a standard pendulum with the weight at the bottom and then a reverse pendulum with the weight at the top. You're encouraged to experiment with fitting your pendulum at different lengths and measuring the swings to calculate the acceleration due to gravity. The more skilled you are at this, the more accurate your results will be. The fifth experiment proves the theory for the bifilar pendulum. This is different to the standard pendulum as it swings around the central axis of rotation rather than left to right. By gently twisting the pendulum by 30 degrees to start the oscillation, you then record how long it takes to complete 50 oscillations, repeating again for different lengths. The sixth experiment proves the theory for trifilar pendulums. It uses the trifilar plate here that is attached to the top plate at specific chord lengths. Firstly, you twist it by 30 degrees to oscillate and measure how long it takes for the 50 occurrences. Then changing the lengths and then add the masses. This is a little more complicated than the other experiments in the kit, but all the theory is supplied in the user guide, along with step-by-step instructions on setup. Further information on the Simple Harmonic Motion Kit can be found in the description box with links. For a deeper understanding of Simple Harmonic Motion, TecQuipment also offers the Simple and Compound Pendulums Experiment and the Filler Pendulums Experiment, both which fit onto the free vibrations test frame. Links are enclosed below. For more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe to TecQuipment's YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.